Hi there guys, this is Celia with Hello Health Net, and I finally put together a little flexibility flow for you, Kayla, as she requested, so it's been long awaited, but here it is. So I just put together a few things that I like to do, and to add on to what I already sent to Kayla. So we're gonna just start seated, and this flow is great to add at the end of the day, or maybe in the morning, just to like stretch out when you need it. So. And it will really help to increase that flexibility. So you can do all of this seated. We're not gonna go into any standing postures, so it's really convenient. But we're gonna start with seated twists. So you can do twists this way and twist, just taking one hand to the back and planting the back hand close behind the hips. Or I wanted to add this twist in. So just bending one leg in front and crossing the opposite leg over, and then anchoring the sit bones to the ground or to your mat. And then as you inhale, just lift up through the chest. Send that arm over behind the knee and plant this back hand close behind your hips. And then you're just gonna breathe into that movement. So every inhale, you'll inhale, lift up through the chest. Every exhale, you'll work your twist to the back. And then as your spine sort of opens up, you can allow that forearm to just maybe gently bend here. I'll show you. Just bend down toward the thigh. So you'll plant that hand right here and just work into that gently so that you're just allowing your spine to create that space and to get into that twist. So the twist is happening right here in the middle of your spine and your belly. So you're just adding a little pressure against your knee and then just working that twist. You're opening the chest, taking it to the side. And then you'll do that on the other side as well. So then the next thing, I've got seated cat-cow. So you're moving from this twist, and then you're just coming and crossing your legs here. And for seated cat-cows, it's the same principle as when you're in tabletop doing cat-cows. We're just gonna take our hands to our knees and find that really straight spine. So there's a wall right here. You can even, if you have a wall that you're practicing near, if you want to check your alignment, just sit straight back against that wall. And you want to work so that the spine is straight against the wall. Sometimes we have a little sway in our backs and we end up having that little arch there. So we want to like tuck in the tailbone just a little bit to get rid of that sway, or at least work towards that. So then we're rolling the shoulders back and down, aligning the hips under the shoulders, under the ears, and then hands rest gently on your knees. So for seated cat-cows, you're just gonna inhale and dip your tailbone forward, almost creating a new sway in your back. So dip the tailbone forward and then arch up through the spine and the chest, taking the head up, just gazing, just creating a nice curve with the spine. So you'll inhale, and then exhale, you'll tuck the tailbone first and round through the spine. So it looks like this, just inhaling and exhaling. So the key here is to initiate the movement from your hips, tailbone, sacrum, pelvic area. So this whole area is what's moving first in both movements, okay? So that'll help you get that upward and the downward motion, and then just breathing along with it. So going at your own pace, the longer you are able to spend in each of these postures, the more results you'll get flexibility wise. So that's fun. All right, next on my list I have pigeon. So if you have a block for a pigeon, if your hips are really tight, then grab a block or maybe even roll up a blanket. And that'll help you get into this pose a little bit better. So I'm just moving some stuff out of the way. Let's just start with the left leg and just take it out in front. So this is your beginning pigeon pose. Your hip is open on this side, it's closed off on this side, but our hips are not square. So they're still facing forward, knee is bent, and the leg comes back here. So eventually you want to work towards maybe pulling this foot in just a bit and then stretching the knee out and squaring up those hips. You can just sink right down into your hips. Now, if this movement is just not available right now, you can literally just work your way into it by leaving your hip open, or you can grab this block and maybe you can get to a point like this. but you don't want to hold that up the whole time. So just place the block right there and sit down right on the block. And this way you can gently work on squaring those hips, but you're supporting your body in the stretch. So it helps you out and you will be able to get into the full expression with the support of the block. So that is that pose. And then we'll go directly from pigeon. Let's see what's next. We'll go directly from pigeon into a straddle. So whatever that looks like for your body, just extend this leg, take this leg out. So you're working that straddle split, right? And this straddle can look like anything for your body. Everyone's body is different. So you will reap the same benefits of stretching no matter where your legs are, if they're right here, here, wherever they are. Maybe you have to bend your knees. No big deal. You are just gently working with your body and where it is. So take the pressure off yourself and allow your body to open as it is ready to, okay? So we're just gonna make sure to roll the quads and the calves back. And then inhale, find that spine again. Move the sit bones out of the way. Find that straight spine. And then do a couple side bends first. So we'll just drape one arm this way and just gently breathe into those side bends. You can take your time here so that when you're in that side bend, hold it for several breaths and just allow your body to sink deeper and deeper into the pose. And then obviously doing it on the other side. So a key here is to open the shoulder. So instead of folding this way, we're gonna roll that shoulder back and even gaze up at the ceiling to help you keep the shoulder and the chest open. And that way you're really stretching out the side body as well as the legs. So then after the straddle, let's just transition right into pigeon on the other side. So we're gonna bend that right leg and work our way. So maybe starting right here and then pulling the leg in a bit more so that you can extend, maybe using this block here and just placing it right under that thigh so you can just sit right there and work those straight square hips. All right, so after that, we're actually gonna work into a long lunge. So you can open your hip just slightly and then maybe use your hands, lift up and take that right leg out to a long lunge. So your leg is going to be very straight in the back and your knee is going to be right over your ankle. So just find that place where you can really sink into your hips here and then maybe even hang out right here or gently come down to your elbows. So for this, this is really opening this hip. It's opening the psoas muscle right in front of your hip. It's very, very good for that hip flexibility. So you're just gonna gently work into this. And you wanna breathe and support your stretch. Really send the oxygen there, help you find that stretch. So once you're here, and maybe you've come all the way down and you've hung out maybe for a minute or maybe less, maybe you've just taken some really good deep breaths into this pose, then you're just gonna walk your hands back and you're gonna plant both hands. And this is my right leg, this is my right arm. They're both inside my foot, right? So my foot's right there. And I'm just gonna twist my right arm up and just rotate through the torso, getting that nice twist again. So just rotate on up. And then you're just gonna take several breaths there, okay? So then we're going to lower down through this leg and take both legs back into the center for a nice bound angle. So just pull those legs in. Soles of the feet together. Maybe place those hands, like grip right around the toe area so the thumb is right behind the toes in that fleshy part right there. And then lift up through the shoulders and the spine. Find that yoga back, straight back. And then just breathe and press the knees down. So you can even take the hands behind the back and do this, just pressing them down, opening the hips, working that flexibility there. Breathing into it, taking several breaths, and then after you breathe through it and sort of settle in, then grab right around the toes again, straighten the spine, inhale to lift, exhale and fold forward so you're folding right at your hips. So make sure to tuck the core in, hug those ribs with your core so that you can forward fold directly from those hips. So when we don't tuck the core, we end up kind of pushing it out, sort of pulling with the core to like take our body down. We want to focus on hinging from the hips. So tucking the core, hinging from those hips, sort of keep that straight back feel. And then when your back is like, eh, I want to bend, I can't keep this straight thing going, then maybe grab a block and maybe put it this way and let your head rest like this. Or maybe you can come all the way down. Or if you don't have a block or a blanket, you can literally just round through the spine. It may not be as comfortable as having a block, but it still works. So you can just round all the way through and hold that for several breaths. You just want to really settle in and let your body breathe through these movements, really getting deep into the connective tissue. So the longer you hold them, the more nourishing it is to your ligaments and your muscles. And I just taught a couple of these in a yin class, and it was so much fun, and it is so good for your body. Really complements the active lifestyle and an active yoga practice, so definitely good to hold them. If you have time, hold these poses for, I mean, a minute or two. If you can do it 2 minutes, do it. If you can go longer, do it. It's great. All right, so from bound angle, we're gonna go into our lunge on the other side, and we're gonna do that twist. So let's just take that left leg out and work the right leg all the way back, just stretching it as much as we can and taking that knee, making sure it's right over the ankle. So then bringing the hand on the inside of the foot and really just keeping that leg so nice and long in the back. So then breathing here, and then when you feel like you're warmed into this, just kind of lower down onto those elbows, working to keep your back straight here, chilling right next to that foot, just really get a nice stretch and take the time to breathe through it. Then when you're ready, come on back up, and we're going to twist the left arm up. So just opening through the chest there, and then you can gently come back up. Let's see what's next. All right, so we're actually gonna take this front leg back, and we're gonna go into a puppy pose. So after that long lunge, you can take your knees right under your hips, almost like you're in tabletop. So here's tabletop. And then we're just gonna walk those hands out as far as we can and really melt the chest and the chin to the mat. So we might even be resting on the chin. We may not be able to get our chest all the way to the mat. This is called puppy pose. It's a heart opener, shoulder opener, really nice back bend. So you just want to work your way all the way down and see if you can get that chest to the floor. So really opening through the shoulders. So you're going to hold there for several breaths. Just allow the shoulders. You can really feel them. You can feel them stretching out and opening. So take your time in that pose. It's a great one. All right, so after puppy pose, we're going to just roll all the way down onto our bellies. And we're going to do another shoulder opener. So shoulders, when they're open, they can really help you get into some important poses such as back bends and so you have improved flexibility when moving your arms, maybe into cow face arms, just so many different things. Shoulder, opening your shoulders is very important, and it will, you know, obviously keep your shoulders healthy. So let's come down to our bellies, and we're gonna start by sending this arm out to the side. Actually, let me start with the other arm. So we're sending this arm out to the side, and then we're rolling onto our side, just like this, and lower the head. So you can see my legs are on the side. We're gonna take our top leg up, step it back and behind our other leg. So our arm is out, our leg is up and supporting, our hands right here. Using this knee as like a lever and pressing into the floor, you're gonna push your body back just a bit onto that shoulder. So just really breathing and pushing back onto the shoulder, and then flip over and do the other side. So you'll take that leg back and do the same thing on the other side. So really hold that for several breaths as well. I mean, all of them. I know I keep saying that. Anyway, what is next? Okay, so after the shoulder opener, we're gonna roll onto our back and go into a hip bridge and then a back bend. So where that shoulder and the shoulder and heart openers really help with these, but we're gonna warm up to the back bend with the hip bridge. So just bend onto your back. And for the hip bridge, you're just gonna take your feet right below your hips, a little bit of space, and take them to hip width distance. Lift up through the hips, and then tuck the shoulder blades down your back. So you can use the floor to help you, just tucking those shoulder blades down the back so your chest is chasing your chin. So you're pressing from your legs, and you're taking that chest up and toward the chin. So see that nice bend? And then taking your hands, clasping them, or maybe holding like this, and then just breathing into this. Holding. So breathe into that. Just really open your back. Really warm it up for a back bend. Okay. And then when we're ready, after that, we're just gonna go into a nice back bend. Now this can be as, there's no pressure here. I don't want you to feel like it's too advanced or anything. So if you can see, we're gonna put our hands right next to our ears and our feet in the same position as the hip bridge. So our hands are facing towards our hips, just like that, or towards the shoulders right here. And they're close, so we wanna keep them close. And when we go into that back bend, we're pressing. So we're pressing to get our arms straight. And then we're pressing into our heels at the same time and lifting our hips. So basically you're gonna go up like this, pressing, and then working those arms so that they're straight and they're not super wide, but they're under your shoulders. And then you can press into your feet. So press from the feet and up through the heart space, right? So we're opening the heart with this and supporting with the legs. So take a few breaths, and then to come out of it, you're gonna tuck your chin in and land on the top of your shoulder blades. So maybe the back of your head rolling down to the shoulders and then roll down through the spine. So good. So just work into that. There is no pressure to be able to do a back bend right away. You can start gently with that hip bridge. That works excellent for your back. Okay, next thing. Okay, I wanted to end with the lying big toe pose and the supine twist. So let's go ahead and find a lying position. And for this one, you're just going to lay all the way down and straighten both legs. So both legs are straightened, right? Pull one leg in and then extend that leg all the way up. So you can reach behind the thigh, behind the calf, up at the toe, and just gently hold this stretch right here. So just tucking that core in again, letting the head rest, but I'm just making sure I can see you. And then relaxing those shoulder blades down the best as you can, and just holding this pose right here, really stretching that hamstring. This stretch you can hold as long as you want. It really feels good on the hamstring. So you'll notice when you hug that knee back in at the end and then extend, your leg's gonna feel a little longer than the other leg. So then you'll pull the opposite leg in. You'll find that placement. You'll just straighten the leg, just work it gently, breathing so that you feel like your breath is allowing you to pull it in maybe a little bit more each time. And just allowing yourself to settle in to wherever this pose is. Just hold it for maybe a couple of minutes if you can, and then release. And then our last thing is supine twist. So right after that, just hug that other knee in. Take that opposite arm, plant this one out here, and just pull it on over. So you really want to plant this shoulder blade to get into that twist. And then breathe, just really allow your spine right here to twist. Sometimes we tend to, our bodies like to fight back sometimes if it feels a little discomfort. So just breathe through it. Allow your body to sink into that pose. Okay, so that was my little flexibility flow for Kayla that she requested. And if you guys have any questions or need clarification, please feel free to send me a message. I hope you enjoyed, and I'm looking forward to doing a few more videos. So send me your requests. I have a couple lined up, so I'm excited. Thanks again. Have a great day.